morning. Have you come to arrange a holiday? Or would you like a blowjob?
I'm sorry.
Oh, you've come to arrange a holiday.
Yes.
Oh, sorry. Now, where were you thinking of going?
To India.
Ah, yes. One of our adventure holidays.
Yes, that's right.
Well, you better see Mr. Bounder about that. Mr. Bounder, this gentleman is interested in the India Overland and nothing else.
Hello, I'm Bounder of Adventure.
Oh, hello, my name's Smoke Too Much.
What?
My name is Smoke Too Much, Mr. Smoke Too Much.
Well, you'd better cut down a little then.
I'm sorry.
You'd better cut down a little then.
Oh, I see. I smoke too much, so I'd better cut down a little then.
Yes. Oh, it's better to get people making jokes about your name all the time, eh?
No, actually, it never struck me before. Smoke too much.
Anyway, you're interested in one of our holidays, are you?
Yes, that's right. I saw your advert in the classified ads.
The what?
In the Times classified ads.
The Times classified ads?
Yes, that's right. I'm afraid I have a speech impediment. I can't pronounce the letter B.
C.
Yes, that's right, B. Yeah. It's all due to a trauma I suffered when I was a schoolboy. I was attacked by a Siamese bat.
A Siamese cat.
No, a Siamese bat. They're more dangerous.
Listen, can you say the letter K?
Oh, yes. Khaki, Kettle, Kipling, Khomeini, Kellogg's Born Flakes.
Well, why don't you say the letter K instead of the letter C?
What, you mean pronounce classified with a K?
Yes, absolutely.
Classified.
Good.
Oh, that's very good. I never thought of that before. What a silly bunt.
Now then, about the holiday.
Yes, I've been on package tours many times before, so your advert really bought my eye.
Good, jolly good.
You're quite right. What's the point of going abroad if you're just going to be treated like a sheep? Carted around in buses, surrounded by sweaty, mindless oafs from Ketchin and Boventry.
Absolutely.
Their bloth bats and their bardigans and their transistor radios complaining about the tea, they don't make it properly, do they? And stopping at endless Majorcan bodegas selling fish and chips and Watney's Red Barrel and calamaris and two veg. Yes. And sitting in their cotton sun frocks squirting Timothy White sun cream all over their puffy, raw, swollen, purulent flesh because they overdid it on the first day.
Yes, I know just what you mean. Now, what
and being herded into Wilderness Hotel Miramars and Bellevues, Bontinentals with their international luxury modern roomettes and swimming pools full of draft Red Barrel and fat German businessmen pretending to be acrobats and forming pyramids and frightening the children and barging into the queues. And if you're not at your table spot on 7, you miss your bowl of Campbell's cream of mushroom soup. The first item in the menu of international cuisine.
Absolutely.
Now, every Thursday night, there's bloody cabaret in the bar featuring some tiny emaciated dago with 9-inch hips. And some fat, bloated tart with her air brill cream down and a big ass presenting flamenco for foreigners.
Will you be quiet, please?
An adenoidal typist from Birmingham with flabby white legs and diarrhea trying to pick up hairy, bandy-legged what waiters call Manuel.
Be quiet.
And once a week, there's an excursion to local Roman remains where you can buy cherryade and melted ice cream.
Will you be quiet?
And bleeding Watney's Red Barrel.
Shut up.
Then one night, they take you to a typical restaurant with local atmosphere and colour. You sit next to a party of people from Rill who keep singing, I love the Costa Brava.
Shut up.
I love the Costa Brava. You get cornered by some drunken greengrocer from Luton with an Instamatic camera and last Tuesday's Daily Express. And
please,
he goes on and on and on about how he ought to be running the country and how many languages Margaret Powell can speak. And she throws up all over the Cuba Libras. Then spending 4 days on the tarmac at Luton Airport on a 5-day package tour with nothing to eat but dried British Airways type sandwiches. You can't even get a glass of Watney's Red Barrel because you're still in England and the bloody bar closes every time you're thirsty. And the kids are crying and vomiting and breaking the plastic ashtrays. They keep telling you it'll only be another hour, but you know damn well your plane is still in Iceland. You have to come back and take a party of... Shut up! Take a party of Sweet Yugoslavia before you load you up at 3 a.m. in the morning. And then you sit on the tarmac for 4 hours because of unforeseen difficulties, i.e. the permanent strike of air traffic control over Paris. When you finally get to Malaga Airport, everybody's queuing for the bloody toilets and queuing for the bloody armed customs officers and queuing for the bloody bus that isn't there, waiting to take you to the hotel that hasn't yet been built. when you finally get to the half-built Algerian ruin, call the hotel bell soul by paying half your holiday money to a licensed bandit in a taxi. There's no water in the pool, there's no water in the bog, there's no water in the tap, there's only a bleeding lizard in the bidet, and half the rooms are double booked, and you can't sleep anyway because the permanent 25 are in the foundations of the hotel next door. Meanwhile, the Spanish National Tourist Board promises you the raging cholera epidemic is merely a mild outbreak of Spanish tummy. Rather like the previous outbreak in 66, even the bloody rats are dying from it.
As early as the late 14th century, or indeed as late as the early 14th century, the earliest forms of jape were divisible...
Meanwhile, the bloody Guardia are busy arresting 16-year-olds for kissing in the street and finding out the last day in the airport lounge. Everybody's buying little awful horrid donkeys with their names on and bought by posters with their own names on, like Antonio Ordenes, Mr. Brian Pures in Norwich, and then finally when you get to bloody Loon, the quad round for bloody